Do you have a standard form that you're trying to move into an online version, but you don't want to spend a lot of time rebuilding the same thing in the online form? Well, if that's the case, then you don't want to miss this video. I'm going to be showing you how you can import an existing form into JotForm in a matter of seconds and have a complete form ready to go that automatically produces PDFs for you as well. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth Pronovost. I am the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools. So if that's of interest to you and you want to learn more about it, do check the links below and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And before I get going on the actual meat and potatoes of today's video, I do want to invite you to join me for my upcoming live training webinar. On this webinar, I teach you the fundamental building blocks of how you can leverage automation to reclaim your time for your business and your job. So if that's of interest, do check the link below or just visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get signed up. Even if you can't attend live, you will get a replay of that recording. And I personally use this very strategy to save over 20 hours a week of my own time. So it's certainly worth an hour to check out seeing how you can leverage these tools as well. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. I want to talk all about importing a form into JotForm. And this is gonna save you a ton of time and makes it really easy and beautiful for you to standardize your forms, those forms that you already have, maybe you're already collecting data, and just drop them right into JotForm, collect all that data automatically, make it clean and easy. Let me show you exactly how this thing works. And we're gonna paint the picture first by imagining that we have to collect W-9 forms from our employees. Now, if you're outside of the US, W-9 is a tax form that we have to have on file as business owners for all the different folks that we're working with. So in this case, I'm going to start with the form. So let's just look up the W-9 form. And be really careful when you're doing this that you're not clicking on ads, whatnot. Make sure you're going to irs.gov and find the form. Now you'll notice that the online version I can type in here and just add whatever information I want and go ahead and fill this out. Then of course I would have to print it and I would then need to sign it because there isn't space here for signature. And of course this thing really slows down the whole process. Then I have to scan it. I'm wasting paper. I have to shred my paper. You get the idea. There's a lot of steps that we don't need to take, right? We can do this electronically to provide our employer or the person who's hiring us as a contractor. We can provide them this information without necessarily having to fill out a hard copy of the form, right? So as an employer, perhaps we want to download this form and give our different employees and contractors a place that they can fill this out online. So first I'm going to start just by downloading this form. Now I'm going to be sure to remove any information that I have in here and just go ahead and save it or download it without the changes that I've made. I'm going to just save this to my desktop for our example, and I can now close out of the form. Now I'm gonna move into JotForm and create a form. And this is the hack, my friends. A lot of people overlook this, but you can import a form and convert an existing form in seconds. And you're gonna see it right now. So I can do it from a web page, pretty cool. Clone an existing form. So if I already have a form in JotForm, I can clone it, or I can just drop a PDF in here. And this is what we're gonna be doing. So let's go ahead and get that PDF. I'm gonna upload my form, and of course I have to find the form wherever I saved it on my desktop, and I'm just going to let this do its thing in the background. I'm gonna have to watch these bars move around for a couple of seconds. It doesn't take all that long, and there we are. We're all set. I didn't speed up that camera at all. That was all real time. And so you see that the really cool part here is that it's captured all of the different pieces of questions in the form, and it's made them available automatically in the form. Now, I do wanna say, it's not 100% perfect. You're probably gonna need to clean this up a little bit. For example, I know from experience every time I do things like the social security number. So you see here, I clicked on the element in the form in the PDF, and it took me directly to that part of the form. And so it has all the text here, but you'll notice that this particular entry here is looking for the numbers to go in the first three of a social. And of course, we know that the social security number is all of these numbers, the first three, the middle two, and then the final four, right? But the form doesn't know that. It thinks they're three different questions, so it's kind of broken them up here. So this is one of those things that you'll need to kind of clean up for yourself. You would just instead give them the total number of digits that they need, allow them to plug it all in, and you should be good to go from there. I'm not gonna worry about cleaning it up. I'm sure that if you are importing a form of your own, you can easily clean it up. You see that you can click here to remove things, etc. Now, also, I do wanna point out that as you're scrolling through here, again, there's an issue with the employer identification number. But if you wonder what this particular part is, all you need to do is click that element and it shows you. Again, it highlights the PDF version and shows you exactly what it looks like. Now, the one part that this missed, first of all, it gave us a lot of language, all of the instructions that we probably don't need. Of course, I would most likely remove them if I were doing this for real. But then, of course, the other part that I do want to include here is a signature. So you do see on the PDF here that there's a place where they're capturing the signature and the date. So in our example, what I'm going to want to do is be sure to add this form element. So again, just, you know, rewinding, this got set up here in a matter of seconds. It's not 100% perfect, but it got us 95% of the way there with a little bit of cleanup. So now I'm going to add that one element. I'm going to go ahead and add a signature element. In a previous video, I went into detail about how you can leverage this signature element, so be sure to check that out if you're curious. But I'm gonna move this on down and drop it right here so that it's the last question. And let's go ahead and map it out. You see that when I've selected here, I now have this green space. I can drag it down here and actually resize it so that it fits in my signature area. Pretty good with that. And we can go ahead and call this done. So, going to publish this form and actually fill out some information just so that we can take a look at it to see what it looks like in real time. So as a user, I would go in and access this form website. Now I could rename this site. So let's say, for example, I wanted to remap it to be W9 and apply, make sure that it's available, and then I can open this up in a new tab. So my team can now just go to this URL, form.jotform.com/pronovost/W9, and start filling out the form. This is exactly what their user experience is going to look like. So they're gonna see whatever the name of the form is here and what the first page of that form looks like in PDF. They can start filling it out. Sure enough, they get all those questions, right? So let's say that they were filling this out as an individual sole proprietor, and I'll just put my name in here briefly. And, you know, filling out all the rest of the information, I'm not going to mess with that, and then sign so they can sign. Of course, mine always looks terrible. And when they're all done reading all of this madness here, then they can submit. Now, before they do that, you notice they get the preview PDF option. So let's take a look and see exactly what this would look like. So once we click in, we see that the name came in properly, but there was an issue with the checked box because if I recall, I marked the individual or sole proprietor. So obviously there's a mismapped field that we would need to fix, but you see that the signature came in just fine as well. So it brought the signature in, etc. So as far as the PDF is concerned, of course, negating the fact that we have a mismapped field here, but the PDF is coming together pretty well. So we can go back to the form and actually submit that data. Then still from my user experience, I can send the PDF as an email or download a copy of it for my own records. But what I'm more excited about as the business owner is being able to capture that information automatically. So if I flip into my email, you'll find that if I refresh it, I have received a new email that's telling me that I got a new submission on that form. So I can open up that form. This is the data that they submitted, but if I scroll down, I get that PDF sent to me. So there is obviously a lot that I can do with this via automation. I could easily send this to a database or some other online repository where I collect all of my W-9s and various other tax documents so that they're all in one place ready to go when it's time to file. So this is a great way that you can, again, move everything online, take those standard forms, but start capturing the data electronically and save some trees in the process. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If this was a new feature that you were unaware of, please give this video a thumbs up and ask any questions you might have below in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.